Welcome students, welcome to the classes of BPharma third semester. This is Rohit Kumar Trivedi. I will be teaching pharmaceutical engineering in this semester. Okay. We have already discussed what is size reduction, what are the basic mechanisms, what are the factors affecting size reduction, what are the principles of size reduction. Okay. And we have already discussed a few size reduction equipment already, like our ball mill, okay, fluid energy mill. Today we will discuss hammer mill. Okay, the hammer mill is a principal equipment that is used in the process of size reduction of pharmaceuticals. Okay, as the name itself is indicating, we will be using certain hammers. Okay, and the hammers will be hitting the object and will be breaking that object into small particles. As you can observe in this figure, okay, we will try to discuss each and every aspect of the hammer mill. This is Rohit Kumar Trivedi. You can follow me on YouTube and Facebook and subscribe my YouTube channel, and you can also share my channel among your classmates too for studying pharmaceutical engineering. Okay, if you have any question, query in your mind, you can definitely ask. I will try to solve all those queries instantly. Okay, now let's start our today's topic, hammer mill. Before starting the study of the hammer mill, we are required to learn what is the principle behind the working of a hammer mill. Okay, we have already discussed the principle like impact and adhesion in my previous lectures. You can get all those lectures in my YouTube channel. Okay, now the principle of the hammer mill is impact. Okay, what exactly impact is? Basically, what will happen in the hammer mill? Here in this figure, you can observe all these large size particles are getting entry into the hammer mill. Okay, in this space, and here you can observe this structure, this dark or blue color structure. Basically, it is a rotatory disc kind of structure. Okay, and the disc is equipped with the hammer. All these outside projections are called as hammer. Okay, what happens? These large size particles enter into the mill, and this high speed rotating disc or high speed rotating hammer hit the object with the principle of impact. Okay, that collision between the large size particles and the hammer of the mill is called as impact, a very strong impact we can say. Okay, and during this process, what happens? Due to impact, the large size particles are reduced into the small size particles. Here in this machine, there are certain other things too. Let's discuss them one by one. Okay, we have already discussed these are the hammers. This is the entry or the feed from where the large size material will enter into the mill. Okay, now here in this area, you can see there is a perforation. Okay, or a screen you can say. This dotted line is a screen basically. It will be having a certain pore size. What will happen during the process of size reduction? Certain particles will be reduced to the smaller particles, and all those small particles who will have the particle size lesser than the pore size of this screen will fall down, and we will be collecting all those small particles into the collector. Okay, and the large size particles will keep on moving inside the hammer mill. Okay, and again the impact will happen, the particle will be reduced into small size, and the small size particles will be screened through this screen, and ultimately we will collect all those small particles. Okay, so we can adjust the size of the screen as per our requirement. Okay, so this is the basic working, basic structure and the principle of hammer mill. If there is a question in your examination, discuss about the size reduction equipment or size reduction machinery that works on the principle of impact, you can definitely write about hammer mill, and you are required to mention each and everything like principle, construction, working, advantages, disadvantages, okay, and the basic uses of hammer mill. Next, let's discuss what are the uses of a hammer mill. Okay, obviously it is a machinery that is used for the process of size reduction. Okay, so obviously in the hammer mill, the large size particle, drug material, we can say excipients, we can say, okay, the bark, leaves and the roots of the plant can also be reduced into smaller size using the hammer mill. And again, milling of the API, API is your active pharmaceutical ingredient. API and the other excipient can also be reduced in size by using the hammer mill. Okay, now moving further, let's discuss the merits and the demerits of the hammer mill. Obviously, when we are studying any machinery, any equipment, any pharmaceutical machinery, there are certain merits but certain demerits too. Okay, keeping in mind all these things, we use our machinery for the process of size reduction or the pharmaceutical processing. Now let's discuss one by one the merits of the hammer mill. The very first is the hammer mill produces numerous size distribution, means a variety of the size material, particle size material will be obtained using the hammer mill. Okay, it will be a major advantage of the hammer mill. It can be used for the variety of the material, means many materials can be reduced in size. Like we have already discussed, we can use the root, bark, leaves, our API, our excipient. Okay, the variety of materials can be reduced very easily using the hammer mill. The installation, dismantle and the cleaning of the material is very easy. Okay, if you are going to install this machine to the particular area, okay, dismantle if you are going to again removing all the parts of the machine and placing that machine to the another area. Okay, it can be done very easily and cleaning of the machinery is very easy. Okay, obviously the maintenance of the machine is very low and very easy, means there is no we can easily maintain or we can easily service our hammer mill in our pharmaceutical industry. There is no very much complicated structure in the ball mill, sorry, in the hammer mill. Okay, we can easily maintain and the maintenance cost is very low, due to which the processing and the ultimately the final product cost is reduced. Okay, next is the manufacturing of the machine is very easy. Okay, there is a moving disc on which the hammers are placed and the circulatory area total and the screen. Okay, and the simple construction is there of our hammer mill. Now let's discuss the demerits of the hammer mill. The very important and the very major disadvantage of the demerit of the hammer mill, we can say it cannot be used for the processing of very fine material. Okay, if we want to have a very fine particle size material, we cannot produce very small particle size material using the hammer mill. It is the major disadvantage of the hammer mill. Next is the hammer mill cannot be used for the low melting point or the sticky material. See what happens during the processing, there will be impact. Okay, force will be generated and energy will be evolved in the form of temperature. Okay, the temperature inside the mill during processing will be increased and the material, those have very low melting point. Okay, and the material, those are sticky, will easily stick to the hammers, to the screen and to the machinery. Okay, it is a major disadvantage of the hammer mill. And again, the materials, those who have lower melting point, may get degraded in the processing of hammer mill. Okay, also this is a major disadvantage of our hammer mill. And we can say the heat sensitive or the thermolabile material cannot be processed in hammer mill. As I have already discussed, the temperature is generated during the process of size reduction in the hammer mill, due to which the thermolabile material may get degraded or chemical degradation may occur due to the increased temperature inside the hammer mill. Okay, so these are the various merits and demerits of our hammer mill. You are required to learn each and everything very carefully. If you have any question in your mind, you can definitely ask. Okay, you can definitely can comment. I will try to answer all questions instantly. Again, this is Rohit Trivedi. You can follow me on YouTube and Facebook as well with Rohit Kumar Trivedi. Okay, do subscribe and hit the bell icon if you want to have all the video lectures. As soon as they are uploaded, you will receive the notification instantly. And also share this channel among your BPharma classmates. This will also help you in preparing your GPAT lectures. Okay, till then, Bye bye and happy learning.